Corins, welcome back to my channel. For those who don't know me, my name is Leslie and I'm all about self-care, whether it's mentally, physically, or spiritually. And today, I'm coming to tell you the truth about going natural. Now, there are a couple of things that people do not tell you before you decide to go that natural route. They're like, big chop, big chop, big chop, and then you big chop and then you don't know how to take care of your hair. You say, well, this YouTuber uses all these products. You buy all those products, you put it in your hair, they don't work. And you're like, what the F? And these hair products, which I'm gonna get into in a moment, are not sometimes the cheapest thing, all right? So I'm gonna give you the five most important things that you need to know before you decide to go natural, because it is a commitment and I do not wanna mislead you. These YouTubers and these Instagrammers, they have time to do these things with their hair, and I'm gonna explain to you, like I said, the five crazy critical things that you need to know before you decide to go natural. Okay? Okay. So do you want me to? First things first, the number one thing that I want you to know that you need to understand before you decide to go natural is that having natural hair takes time. And when I mean that it takes time to manage it, it takes time to get your hair in a place where you accept it, it takes time all around. So I want to explain to you something. I was one of those people that was a part-time natural girl. When you're part-time natural girl, that means you go to the hair salon like once a month or once every 2 months, right? You get a blowout and then you put your hair, you put gel in it all the rest of the time because it did curls and it was good enough. I was one of those people until I decided that I really wanted to see how far I could take my hair. One of the misconceptions that I had is that, oh, okay, like I'll jump in the shower, I put gel in it and I'm Gucci. That's not it. So not only do you have to deep condition your hair, right, and let that sit, you have to also remember that you have to, you know, obviously you wash it and you condition it and you have to leave the conditioner in the hair just like you would in a regular hair salon. But you also have to remember that you have to put the product in your hair, you have to let it sometimes air dry, and if you're diffusing your hair, that takes so much time. And then if you diffuse your hair, or if you don't diffuse your hair, you air dry it and it's not big enough, you have to take the time to pick it. I sometimes take 4 hours just for my hair to be completed. Not going to the hair salon and waiting for my turn. Like, no, I'm literally waiting for my hair to dry. And the worst part is that sometimes I have to do my hair more than once in a week because I go to the gym every day, which means that I'm sweating, which means my curls are not gonna last as long as somebody who just goes to the office and comes home and doesn't work out. Right? So not only do I have to worry about doing my regular hair care routine, I have to replenish my hair throughout the week, and that takes time. And then if you like your curls a certain way, like twist, oh my God. Oh my God. Okay? All right? So don't let these people fool you. It's not easier going natural. You might want to do it for self-love purposes. Oh, I want to accept my natural hair, but it still takes work. Just like going to the gym, just like doing anything in life, it's literally a part-time job going natural. Number one, time consuming. And like I said, I'm telling you this because I'm going to tell you the truth. People are like, oh yeah, heat is bad for your hair, but boobs, some people need to put heat to their hair because they're lazy, all right? And that's okay. That is okay, all right? So the number two thing that people don't tell you about are all the tools that you need to get before you decide to go natural. It's not just a brush and a comb, sis. It's just not, all right? There's different tools for different reasons. I'm gonna give you like 8 of them really fast, okay? You're gonna need, like I said, a brush and a comb. Those are basic. You need something, right, to sleep in your hair at night. A lot of people don't realize you have to wrap your hair. Just because your hair is curly don't mean you could just go free falling, right? And then some people like to get a satin pillowcase because it makes your hair last a little bit longer, and if it falls off, right? Your hair is still protective. So I have both. Well, actually I use three things, but I digress, all right? So you need something to protect your hair, something to sleep on. You need sometimes, you don't need this, but a lot of people do need it. If it's cold, you need a diffuser with a blow dryer that has cool heating temperatures, because that's very important for you not being able to go outside in the cold with wet hair, right? You need clips, right? You need all different types of combs. You need a pick, you need a detangler, you need a wide tooth comb, you need a soft brush, you need a hard brush. That's nine, right? There are so many things that you need and you have to be prepared for it. Some people have blow dryers in their house. You know, I have a microfiber towel, I have extra t-shirts for my hair so that way it doesn't frizz, because there's so many important steps into having those Instagram hair curls, okay? So just keep that in mind, that your, you know, regular comb is not gonna rock, all right? And you're gonna need to protect your hair, because once you get the curls that you want, you're not gonna wanna do those steps every day. You can't wash your hair every day, because if you're anything like me, you have to have a lot of moisture in your hair, and you wanna make sure that you have stuff to protect that moisture, and you wanna make sure that you have the things that help you have the volume and the curls that you want, okay? So number one's time, number two is tools, okay? All right, so the number three thing that people don't tell you about your hair is that if you go and buy hair products, right? You know, you wanna know, you know, what hair porosity that you have, and I'll get into that. You wanna know certain things about your hair. Just because a product works on your hair the first time does not mean it's gonna work the second time. Your results will vary. It never is the same way. And you're probably like, how is that possible? If I'm using, you know, shampoo, conditioner, and then I go straight into leave-in, and I go right into my styling cream, it should have the same result, right? Wrong. You know why? Because the weather changes. If it's humid outside, your hair will do something different. If it's winter, forget about it. Your hair is just drier because it's just winter. Sometimes your hair is just too much product on it and it's like, eh, I don't wanna do anything. And you have to figure it out. So, with that being said, you'll need more hair products, okay? Not only will you need, you know, hair products to get the buildup out, you need oils, you need all these things for whatever emotional state your hair is in. Your hair has feelings. You know what, when I was younger, I used to talk to my hair, but it's mostly because I'm tender-headed. I used to be like, oh my God, don't hurt me. But what I will say is that once you get the hang of it, you start to learn what your hair is needing. Like sometimes I'm like, I cannot use a gel. If I use a gel, my hair is gonna fall out, I already know. So I'll just stick with creams and, you know, a really healthy, natural products. I know that about my hair, but understand that not one brand sometimes is gonna get you the look that you're looking for all the time. So even my favorite hair company, Organic Girl, is like my favorite hair company. There are times where I'm like, oh my God, like what are you doing today? Because my hair is just not in its state. So don't get upset, don't get frustrated. Just understand that it's okay, that your hair has its moments and it's gonna do what it wants to do, and you have to accept that. You don't know what's gonna happen the next day, okay? All right, so the number four important thing that you need to know before you decide to go natural is that getting the curl pattern or the curls that you want takes time. Sometimes it's not gonna happen the first wash, it's not gonna happen the second wash. It sometimes takes a couple of months for your hair to take to product and be natural, and I know that can be a little bit frustrating. You go a couple months and you're like, oh my God, when am I gonna see results, or when am I gonna see the curls that I'm gonna see? That comes with a lot of learning and understanding products, and understand what products have sulfates and silicones, and what silicones does to your hair, and sulfates do to other people's hair. Like, it's dramatic. So you wanna make sure that you understand that you're gonna need patience, especially if you're trying to get your hair to grow. Yes, there are certain things that you can do to manipulate that, like eating healthy, exercising, and taking multivitamins to get your hair to grow faster, but it still takes patience. And like I said, I'm gonna say, you know, you see these YouTube girls, they have these long curls all the way down, just down their back, and it's just curls for days, right? Some people's hair grows differently. my hair is like all the way down to here, right? If I pull it, but shrinkage, nobody knows. Nobody knows how much my hair has grown because it popped right back up. Some people's hair just grows this way instead of this way. And that's just life. But you also have to understand and love your hair, and you'll be like, all right, cool, bet. I'm gonna know everything I need to know about my hair and what it needs to do and how I'm gonna let it grow. All right? And then number five, last but not least, understand that you are not gonna have the curl pattern of the girl in the picture. I have yet have met someone with the same hair type as me. Or let me say that in a different way. It's not hair type. It's a matter of, we might have the similar hair, but we can't use the same products because her hair and her body is going through different things than my hair and my body. I swore that me and Bianca Renee has the same curl pattern, same texture, same everything. And no matter what I do, I can't get her results because I'm not Bianca Renee. So understand that your hair and your curls are gonna be unique to who you are. So don't get frustrated if you don't look like these girls on Instagram. You're gonna have your own curl pattern, your own style, and then there's gonna be people who are jealous of your style. You know, some people are gonna be like, yo, I wish I had tight curls like that. And some people are gonna be like, oh my God, I wish I had loose curls like that. Me, I don't know what I want. I really genuinely just want it to look like it's long. Probably will never happen. It'll probably shrink forever because I did something to somebody in my past life and I'm just gonna have short looking hair all the time. But that's okay. That is okay. And you will accept it, and boo, accept your hair, love yourself, and move forward. So those are the five things I want you guys to understand, all right? Because if you don't get that in your head, that it takes time and it's gonna cost you money and there's gonna be a learning curve, and you have to accept your hair and you have to be prepared. You know, the first couple of months of your hair journey is not gonna go that well. If you don't have nothing to wrap your hair with, girl, you're already destroying yourself. If you prepare to fail, then you fail to prepare. But is that what it is? If you fail to prepare, you prepare to fail. That's what it is. So make sure that you understand, watch YouTube videos, see what other people are doing, find out, but don't freak yourself out. You know, there's so many rules out here. Some people say don't put heat to your hair at all. You can never straighten it. You can use sulfate, silicones, whatever. Figure out what works with your hair. There's no right or wrong. And although most of the time I don't use any sulfate, silicones, and things like that, chemicals, parabens, mineral oils, I don't usually use any of those things. Sometimes a sister just wants a wash and set. All right? And that's okay. And that is okay. Don't let anybody make you feel bad for going and getting a wash and set and blowing out your hair and straightening it every once in a while. I'm not saying doing it for special occasions, because you should be able to wear your natural hair for special occasions as well. Your hair is beautiful for all occasions. But don't make anybody feel bad for you doing what you need to do for you, boo. All right? I love you, unicorn, so much. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and love me, because I'm going to do another video next Wednesday. Wash Day Wednesdays all day. And I love you guys so much. I'll see you next week. Bye, unicorns.